Hello everybody, today I have this Freightliner Cascadia from the year 2015, and the problem that we have is that the clutch got destroyed, as you can see. The problem that this clutch was doing is the one I'm going to show you right now. What it was causing is whenever you were pressing the clutch, it was like pulsating, it was like kicking back. In out, you can feel it on your foot when you're pressing the clutch. That means that the bearing is completely bad. If your engine, I mean your truck, does that means that you have to replace the clutch. In this case, the bearing got completely destroyed. It's actually the first time I see this, but anything can happen. This cannot be reused at all. If you think we can repair it, no, we cannot repair it. We have to sell a new clutch because the clutch is already on his limit over here, as you can see. So the clutch gotta be replaced completely. A couple other things got bad, got destroyed at the same time this happened. The fork then activate the clutch too, got destroyed from here. The bushing got completely destroyed, so it has to be replaced. The slave cylinder got destroyed too. It's leaking a lot of liquid, clutch, that's brake fluid in this case. So it's leaking a lot, and that is bad. We have to install a new one as well. So it happened for the same problem. And this is in a okay condition, and that the flywheel is in a okay condition. Also, this one got destroyed too. The pilot bearing, you can see, doesn't move at all. It's stuck, so it has to be replaced. So in this case, I'm gonna be replacing the flywheel with a new one because this flywheel suffers some damage, and I'm gonna be replacing with a new one. You can resurface the flywheel if you want, but I prefer always to install a new one because this is part of the balance of the engine. If the flywheel loses its balancing, the engine will start vibrating. We will have a lot of vibration, and that will cause many problems when you're driving. So that's the reason why I'm going to sell a new one. And that's what I'm gonna do to fix this problem. I'm gonna replace a couple parts. Also, I'm gonna replace the motor mounts and everything. If you wanna know how to replace a clutch, you can check my video in this corner right now where I did a video how to replace the clutch. Some details are going to be different depending on the trucks, but the basics is the same. So pretty much this is all I'm going to be showing you about the problem that this truck had. If you have any questions about this video, you can use the comment section below to leave questions, recommendations, or anything then you have to add or you wonder about this video. You can comment below, so I can answer it myself, or if you have the time to answer it, please do it as well. Sometimes I have no time to answer other comments, but I'll try my best to answer all of them. If you wanna send support to my channel, you can check the video description below where I have details how to send support to my channel so I make more videos like this for everybody that wants to learn more about trucks. Like, share, subscribe, and thank you for watching.